everybody. It's Doreen, and I'm back today with my actual first haul of the year. And it's actually, I believe, I haven't done a haul in sometime last year, and that's been because of the problems I've been having with my shoulder and my hand. I haven't been able to do any card making, but I have done some embroidery and some jewelry. But this is all going to be about the haul that I have for today. Now, this haul is from a scrapbooking show that I went to this past weekend, and I didn't go to one when it was here in Milwaukee last year, but I did go to the one in Chicago, and I think I did a video on some things that I picked up at that time. But before I go ahead and get started with my haul, I want to give a shout out to Audrey, whose YouTube channel is So Good All. Every year, she has been going to the scrapbooking show that's in Milwaukee, and I have been trying to run into her, and we've never caught up with each other because either I go the first day and she goes the second day, or vice versa. So I was standing in line getting ready to pay for something, and she walked by me, and I knew her right away, but I got so tongue-tied, I couldn't think of her name, I couldn't think of her channel, but she noticed me, and she said, "Are you Doreen?" And I said, "And you are, and I'm sorry, Audrey, I called you Jim Zile," and then you said you were Jim Zile, and then you said, "No, wait a minute, no, I'm So Good All." I'm so used to seeing So Good All, Scrap the World, and Jim Zile, which is Tamika and Cheryl together, I just got completely tongue-tied and couldn't remember her name or Audrey's name or her channel. But I watch all three of them, and they look like they have a blast when they get together. I was just sorry I didn't get to meet the other two. So what I want to say is, I was so glad I finally got to meet you, Audrey, and hopefully we'll meet each other again when the scrapbooking shows come up again. So let me go ahead and get started with my haul, because I do have a lot of stuff that I did purchase, and hopefully I'm going to be able to get back into my card making soon. Like I said, I'm still having the problems with my shoulder, and it just looks like it's just never going to heal, and it's probably because I'm not doing what they recommended that I do. I just cannot not craft. So, first of all, I got this bag that looks like this, and you get this when you sign up to be on their mailing list. Now, I'm already on their mailing list, and I receive coupons and everything, but I didn't sign up for the early bird special or to get there early, because I just didn't think I was really going to go, because as I said in my previous videos, I'm trying to use up some of the stuff that I have right now, because eventually I'm going to be retiring, and I need to make room for when we move. I've got to have some place to put all this stuff, because I am leaving Wisconsin and moving someplace else. So what I have in this bag is, I don't know if some of you have seen the Gina K foil that she has out now, but I purchased some of that, and I also found out that she has a store here in Milwaukee. I don't know how I missed that, but I definitely will be checking that out. But at this particular booth, which was called, get the card out, Craft Fancy, and they do have a website. It's www.craftfancy.com. They're actually located in Arlington Heights, Illinois, which I've actually been there because I went with my husband. I think it was last year we went to the racetrack. Well, he went to the racetrack while I went to a yarn expo. And then once I was done shopping at the yarn expo, I met him at the racetrack in Arlington Heights. So I didn't know this place was there. Had I known that, I probably would have stopped there as well. But anyway, I've gotten the I'm going to put a link up here in the video of how she, Gina K, has demonstrated how to use these foils and these foil mates. So basically, the design is already there and it's in black. And what you do, and I apologize ahead of time for the glare, is the foil will stick wherever you have the black space. Now, you do have to use a laminator for this, and I do have one. You can pick up an inexpensive laminator. I picked up one at Walmart, and I actually picked one up for Skylar, too, because we were going to use it for something else, and we never did. So, I got one with the birthdays, essentials, and then one as a background. So, I have that, and then I also picked up some more of the foil to use. And with this set, you get enough to do 12 cards, and you can go ahead and just take your die and cut out just one of these. You don't have to use the whole thing for one card, so that was pretty good. And then I also bought some more of the deco foil in an iridescent color, and then I think this color is rainbow. So it looks like that. So that's what I picked up at that booth. So I'm going to move on. And then I stopped at a booth. And actually, I was at that particular booth when I ran into Audrey. So then I stopped at another booth. And they were doing kind of a make and take. And she was giving a demonstration on how to use the watercolor paints. Well, I was gonna buy the watercolor paints, but then I thought, well, I already got watercolor paints right here. So anyway, I went on and decided to do the demo anyway. And basically, she gave us a stencil, and you just traced the stencil with the light pencil, the design, and then you colored it in with the watercolor paints. Now, mine is kind of messy because I was doing this really, really quick. But I want you to notice the glitter in there and that shine. What do you think this is? No, it's not glitter. And as many of you have seen, if you watch my channel, you know when I do use the watercolor paints that I'll use, take and put a drop of what is called iridescent medium in the watercolor paint, and then I'll take a brush. Let me see if I have one of my brushes here real quick. I'll take my brush that has water in it and squeeze some water in there and then do my painting to get this look. Well, I don't know where I've been. I've been under a rock someplace and didn't know about these pens, but they're called Wink of Stella brush. And that is what this is. So no more having to dip the eyedropper into the iridescent medium and then dipping that into the watercolor paint and then squeezing a little bit of water in there. Now, you can do that still too, and I probably still will do this because these pens are not that, they're not cheap. They're, well, I got this one for $5.99, and this one is actually the glitter white is what it's called. I thought I was getting a clear, but I mean, that's okay. I can still use this one too. But this is what gave it that shine, and I don't know if the camera will pick up that shimmer, but it's basically just like a shimmer paint. So like I said, I'd never seen these, or I hadn't seen anybody using them on YouTube. I guess I just was under a rock someplace and I just missed it. So, I was glad to see something new. And then, I stopped at this booth called Scrap That. I've been there before. And basically, they have paper and double-sided tape and so forth. Now, I went there. because I definitely didn't want to get any more paper because I just don't need any more paper. But I wanted to get some more double-sided tape. The problem is I couldn't remember which one I had an abundance of. I couldn't remember the width. And I stood there for a minute and I kept looking at them. And then I tried to picture where I keep my tape, double-sided tape, in my craft room. And I'm thinking in my head, okay, which one is it? Which one is it? And I actually was going to call my husband and ask him to go in my craft room and tell me which container had an abundance of a particular size. But then I thought, no, I don't want him in my craft room because when he can't find it, he's going to be moving things around. And I kind of got it where I know where things are. So I just said, I'm going to take a wild guess and guess that I need it this size, which is basically the quarter inch. Well, guess what? I got home and realized this is the one that I already have about 12 rolls of this size. It was this size that I really needed because I only have this one and one more. So now I've gotten two more. So eventually I will get the other size. What I should have done is wrote it down because I knew I needed the tape. I just didn't write down what size that I needed. So now I got two of those along with the other ones that I have. So let me pull out my next one, and I apologize ahead of time for the noise that the paper is going to be making. I stopped at this booth. It's called Stamp On It, and they actually gave you a 15% coupon that you can use all year long. The coupon doesn't expire until the 31st of this year. If you want to go on their website is stamponit.net. So, what did I pick up from there? Well, I picked up, there was a young lady there doing a demo, and she was using, and I'm going to apologize right now because a lot of stuff that I got has a lot of glare to it. But she was using these acetate sheets, and what she basically did was she pulled one out, and then she painted some of it, or I'm sorry, she put paper behind it, and then she had another one that she took and she painted, and then she put glitter on it. And I just really liked the effect that it did. So I bought this particular one. They had tons of all kinds. And then I bought a clear one that you can actually run through a laser jet printer, which I have, or an ink jet printer. So, and it also says if you're using a permanent ink like stays on, you need to heat set it before you can go ahead and do your painting or add in your glitter or whatever you're going to add. So I picked up those two along with she was using something called 3D crystal lacquer glue, and it also has a fine point tip, and it's probably just like glossy accents, but I grabbed it anyway because I liked the effect that it did better than what the glossy accent does. She was also using this as well, so I grabbed that, and then I grabbed some of these peeling sticks. Basically, I got one for sympathy because lately I've been having to make a lot of sympathy cards, unfortunately. So I thought I would put that on a sympathy card when I have to. And then naturally I grabbed some happy birthday ones because that's pretty much all the kind of cards that I make is birthday cards. So I grabbed those little stickers. And then I grabbed some extra tips for the 3D lacquer. And I'm actually going to use this too for the glossy accents. If I can, or I'm going to try anyway. And then, because I use glitter a lot, I got these little mini spoons. You get six in a pack for pouring my glitter on. You can also use a coffee filter or dump your stuff in a coffee filter and just move your whatever you're putting glitter on around, but I grabbed those anyway because I've been looking for something like this. So that's what I got from Stamp On It. My original reason why I decided to go to the show is everybody knows how I love bling if you watch my channel. Well, I always stop at this one particular vendor who has just tons and tons and tons and tons of bling. Well, imagine how disappointed I was, and because he didn't have as much as he normally has, so I didn't get to pick out that much, because a lot of the bling, I had the colors already, and I was going back to get colors that I had ran out of. Sorry about that, I had to step away. I was getting a text, actually, from Skylar. So, anyway, as I was saying, I wanted to go back there because I wanted to get some colors that I had ran out of. And, unfortunately, he didn't have them, the colors that I was looking for. But I did get this one, and I was looking for the one that was like this, that the bling was gold. Because I used all of that I had when I made some frames, I think, that I'm not sure if I've done a video on those yet. But I may be doing a video on some shadow boxes that I did, and I used my embroidery machine to do that. So I had to get just this color, which is fine because I can always use that color, but I was really hoping that he had the other color. And then I bought some more of the bling trim. I was out of the gold, so I got that one. And I didn't have this orange color, so that was a new color for me. And I didn't have this like turquoise color, so that was a new color. And I'm going to move that so you can see that's a turquoise color. And then he had these ultra-fine mister sprays, so I grabbed these because I like to make my own glimmer mist. I finally went ahead and threw out the ones that got messed up when I added those BB to the glimmer mist. I'm still so disappointed on going ahead and doing that because I ruined so many containers of glimmer mist. And if you watch my very first video, you'll see how many glimmer mist I had purchased and how I end up having to throw them all the way because they change colors. And whatever you do, do not add BBs to your glimmer mist. It will change the color. Okay, and so the last thing I purchased from there was just a glitter duster brush to brush off glitter when I put glitter on my cards. And I apologize if I keep shaking the camera. I don't know why that's happening because it normally doesn't. If I didn't say, I got this everything from a vendor called Tall Mouse. And their website is it's the number 8. So it's creativearts.com, and I will put a link to all of the vendors in the description box below. So I'm not going to say what each item is. I'll just put a link to each vendor in case you're interested. It was called Scrabooking Closeouts LLC, and they do have a website. It's called scrapbookingclosesout.com. And with this, all of the Jolie stickers were, and not these particular ones were $1 each, and you know why I grabbed that, because of the bling. And I actually think I'm gonna do some beading around these. But all of the Jolie stickers were buy one, get one free. And they were all a dollar. Yes, they were a dollar. So if you bought one, you got one free. So I have this one. I have this one. And I don't actually know why I picked this up, because I don't know anybody right now that's having a baby. All of my friends are, like, you know, much older, so no one's having a baby. But I grabbed it anyway. You never know. And then, of course, I had to get this. And you all know why. Because it's purple, of course. And it's bling. So I got that. And I grabbed some Christmas ones, because I can always use those on my Christmas cards. And then I picked up this to put on some of my male friends or guy friends for birthday or Father's Day or whatever. And I just picked this up because I thought it was cute. This one and that one. And then I think that's it for the Jolie. Oh no, I have one more. It's a little recipe book and then a recipe card. And I'm sure I'll be using this on a card for my son, since he's a chef. And then, of course, I needed more pop dots. Well, I really didn't need more, but you can never have enough pop dots. So the pop dots were also a dollar, and you get 100 for a dollar. And then foam tape was also a dollar. So I got some more foam tape. And then here's some more 3D foam dots. I think she said there were 100 in a pack, and these were a dollar. And then I got this stamp scrubber for a couple of bucks. I can always use that to clean my stamps, because I am trying to do some more stamping. And then the other thing that was buy one get one free were the stickers. So I got this particular one, this one, and I've gotten this one, and you're probably not going to see this, and this one. I just have such a glare here. And these, and you can use these because you pull them up to put on your cards. So I got that one, and then I got this one. So those were buy one, get one, and they were a dollar. So they had a lot to pick through, and after a while I got tired of picking through everything, so I just grabbed what I got and got out of there, because there were a lot of people in that particular booth. So that's it for that. So now I'm going to pause the video and come back with part two.